Good morning and welcome here to Calvary United Methodist Church. I'm Pastor Beth and I am very honored to be Nikki and Mike's pastor here at Calvary. So I welcome you from wherever God has brought you today to celebrate the life of Lynn Brose. We welcome you in Christian fellowship, recognizing that we come from many different walks of life. As you gather here in this sanctuary, know that this is a very family-friendly space. Noise does not bother me as a mother of three. We also want to let you know the restrooms are just down the hallway here. We do have an active preschool going on, so if you hear some ruckus out there, that's them. We just want to welcome you this morning to our service, and we're going to celebrate Lynn's life, celebrate the resurrection of each one of our lives, and then afterwards we invite you all downstairs to the fellowship hall for a light luncheon. In which you can share additional stories about Lynn and gather with her family. Dying, Christ destroyed our death, and rising, Christ restored our life. Christ will come again in glory. As in baptism, Lynn put on Christ, so in Christ may she be clothed with glory. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore. And I hold the keys of hell and death. Because I live, you shall also live. Friends, we have gathered here to praise God and to witness our faith as we celebrate the life of Lynn. May we come together in grief, acknowledging our human loss, and may God grant us grace that in pain we find comfort, in sorrow we find hope, and in death we find resurrection. I invite you into a time of worship, as you share with me the call to worship this morning. O God, you have been our dwelling place in all generations. You are our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. As in baptism, Lynn put on Christ, so in Christ may she be clothed with glory. I invite you to sing with me hymn number 77, which will also be on the screen.
Ah!
I invite you to share in this unison prayer with me. Almighty God, from whom we come and to whom our spirits return, grant us your blessing in this time. Enable us to put our trust in you, that our hearts may find comfort. Lift our eyes beyond the shadows of this world and help us see clearly the light of eternity. May we find grace and strength for this and every time of need through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. This morning I'll share with you words of hope and resurrection from both the Old Testament and the New. And we will share together the Psalm of Comfort, Psalm 23. But first, a reading from Isaiah chapter 40. Comfort, comfort, my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry to her that she has served her term, that her penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out, in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all the people shall see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, cry out! And I said, what shall I cry? All the people are grass. Their constancy is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades, when the breath of the Lord blows upon it. Surely the people are grass. The grass withers, the flowers fade. But the word of our God will stand forever. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I invite you now to join with me the reading of Psalm 23, both in your bulletin and on the screen. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long. Now, it's been brought to my attention many of you are from the Catholic faith and can help with this hymn. So will you join me in the singing of On Eagle's Wings? Guys would be able to do that. Thank you so much. That means a ton to the family. At this part of our service, we like to share reflections of Lynn's life, and I'm very happy to say that Mike Pumphrey and Nikki's given me some thoughts to share, but Mike is going to come up and share some reflections on Lynn's life.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I try my best to get through it. For those of you that don't know me, I'm Mike Pumphrey. I'm Lynn's son-in-law. When I thought about what I'd like to say about Mom this morning, two words immediately came to mind: cold ketchup. I know that sounds pretty strange, but just hear me out for a minute. Not long after Nikki and I met, her folks invited us for dinner. I had already met them previously, but this would be the first time that we'd eaten together. I can't say that I can remember what the meal was that was served, but I do remember that ketchup was offered as a condiment. Nikki quickly mentioned that Mike only eats cold ketchup. While I prefer it cold, it doesn't really matter. I have some food hang-ups, don't we all? Lynn unnecessarily apologized. The next time we ate at their house, Mom had a separate ketchup. Sorry. She had a separate ketchup in the fridge just for me and my two kids. Over the years, the cold ketchup versus the room temperature ketchup became a running joke between us. But it was much more than that. That small act of kindness to make me happy quickly showed me the type of person that Mom was. Her concern was always doing what she could to make others happy or to lessen their burden. She accepted me, Gwyneth and Colin, into the family. And it didn't matter that we weren't related by blood. I can tell you that I love Mom wholeheartedly, and yet I received that in return tenfold. Kindness, thoughtfulness, and service to others are some of Mom's best qualities. I'm sure that many of you here today can think of your own cold ketchup memory of Lynn, where she supported you, made you feel welcome, or just did that little extra something to spread joy in your day. I love you, Mom, and I look forward to seeing you again.
As I share Nikki's email to me, let's compose ourselves for a minute. Nikki and I are about the same age and have very similar relationships to our mothers. And so walking with Nikki in these past few months has been difficult for me personally, because I see so much of that relationship. And I just want you to know, you made me reach out to my parents in a special and a unique way. I'll tell you about it later, but as I try to get through these words, I might have as much difficulty as you. So this is from Nikki. She sent me this email this morning at 12:33 a.m. Mom taught me to love music as she sang along to John Denver, Neil Diamond, and Kenny Rogers while working around the house. She taught me to love and care for pets. She showed me how to care for aging relatives by her example. She took Dad's father, my pop, to the doctor, pharmacy, and grocery countless times. She was tireless and never complained while caring for her own parents. Mom loved being a grandmother. She went to preschool events, elementary school plays, Cub Scout, trunk or treating, Boy Scout promotion ceremonies, basketball games, soccer practices, football games, choir, and band performances. We were so grateful when she offered to host a weekly family dinner so Mike could see Gwen and Colin every Tuesday. Mom had a sense of adventure. She liked to travel. She even went on a cruise with my mother-in-law, Pat. Mom had a strong Catholic faith. She prayed her rosary when she felt worried or anxious, often going to a local park to be surrounded by nature. Mom loved a good list. She was a list maker extraordinaire. She had lists of what to pack for every type of vacation, lists of foods and who brought what to Thanksgiving dinners. She had all of the lists neatly typed on 3x5 cards. Because of her kind-hearted nature, Mom would not want us to be sad. She would rather we find her spirit in the song of a bird, the joyous greeting of a beloved pet, or the sight of a beautiful sunrise. Thank you so much, Nikki. As we share in the continued readings this morning, I'd like to read from the gospel lesson according to John, chapter 14. Jesus said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, but believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again, and I will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you also may be. And you know the way to the place I'm going? I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. Because I live, you also will live. I have said these things to you while I am still with you, but the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Dear friends, we are gathered here to celebrate life. Oftentimes in a memorial service, we celebrate life and we focus on that celebration of life, but we often forget the promise of resurrection. And the reason we don't talk about that is that's not words we use in everyday language anymore, is it? But we come together to celebrate resurrection, a healing and a wholeness of one's life and spirit and soul. We gather together to celebrate Lynn, and And we are reminded of the beautiful tapestry of roles that she embodied. Wife, mother, sister, grandmother, brownie troop leader, caregiver, organizer, and yes, lover of 3x5 cards. Every thread woven into her life reflects the love and care and dedication she poured into every role that she embraced. So in the midst of our grief, we find solace in the words of the hymn of promise. It speaks of a promise of new beginnings, of God's faithfulness enduring through all seasons of life. Lynn lived out this promise, embracing each new day with courage and faith, trusting in the goodness of God's plan. The prophet Isaiah reminds us of the everlasting strength found in God. Do you not know? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth, the ends of the universe. He will not grow tired or weary, and his understanding no one can fathom. In the majesty and the magnificence of this kind of God that goes beyond our earthly borders into our universe, Lynn found strength in God's unfailing love. Drawing on God's endless well of grace in times of joy and also in times of sorrow and trouble. And so these words that we hear from the Gospel of John offers us words of comfort to his disciples, promising them peace in the midst of uncertainty. Jesus' words, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you." Like the disciples, Lynn found peace in the assurance of God's presence, even in the darkest of times. So as we reflect on Lynn's life, as we celebrate Lynn's life, as we celebrate the gift and the promise of resurrection, let us hold fast to these promises of God that we have proclaimed today. Let us take comfort in knowing that she now rests in the loving arms of her Heavenly Father, where there is no more pain, there is no more suffering. And let us carry on her legacy of love, her legacy of caregiving, of comforting, of cold ketchup. Let us aspire to be that kind of person who makes sure there's two bottles of ketchup on the table. Let us carry on that legacy of love, of faith, of service, knowing that her spirit lives on in each one of you, on each act of kindness that you give to a member of your family, to the community, to the people that have been marginalized and infringed. Let that act of kindness be a reminder of what Lynn has imparted on your life each and every day. So as we conclude our service today, we will sing the hymn of promise. That wasn't planned, but it fits perfectly with what Nikki reflected in her memories of her mom, but also in the memories that I've heard from all of you. May the hymn of promise continue to echo in our hearts, reminding us of God's faithfulness and the hope that we have in Christ. Amen. As we commend Lynn to the spiritual bond, we are reminded that while she's here, she's not here anymore. She is with her Heavenly Father. She is without pain, without suffering, without the bodily things that we sometimes see deteriorate as we get older. And so a hymn of thanksgiving, a prayer of praise and commendation as we pray together. Will you pray with me? God of us all, your love never ends. When all else has failed, you are still God. and your love has always remained steadfast with us. We pray to you for one another in our need, and for all anywhere who mourn with us this day. To those who doubt, give light. To those who are weak, provide strength. To all who have sinned, Lord, grant mercy. To all who sorrow, Lord, give your peace. Keep true in us the love with which we hold one another. In all our ways, we trust in you. God of love, we thank you for all which you have blessed us, even to this day, for the gift of joy and days of health and strength, and for the gifts of your abiding presence and promise. In days of pain and grief, we praise you for the homes and friends, and for our baptism and place in your church. With all who have faithfully lived and died, and above all else, we give you thanks for Jesus, who knew our grief, who died our death and rose for our sake, and who lives and prays for us, and as he taught us, so we now pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against you. But deliver us from evil, for thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. I invite you to join me now in the singing of the hymn of promise. Now may the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named, according to the riches of God's glory, grant you to be strengthened with might through God's Spirit in your inner being, that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, being rooted and grounded in love, may be able to comprehend with all the saints, that is, the breadth and the length and the height and the depth, and to know the love of Christ, which surpasses all knowledge, that you may be filled with the fullness of God. May it be. Amen. This concludes our service here. We invite you downstairs for a time of fellowship and gathering with the family, sharing more memories of Lynn. If you're in need of the handicap access, the ramp outside will take you around, and there's another ramp on the back side of the building to get into the fellowship hall, which is downstairs. So go in peace, and may God be with you. Amen.
Thank you.